हेलो एंड वेलकम टू आरोग्य फिजियो टिप्स. आरोग्य फिजियो टिप्स में आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है. इन टुडेज वीडियो आई बी टॉकिंग अबाउट अ कॉमन कंडीशन दैट इज सीन इन द एल्बो कॉल गोल्फर्स एल्बो. सो मोस्टली यू हैव टू कंडीशंस दैट अफेक्ट द एल्बो. द मोर कॉमन वन इज टेनिस एल्बो विच यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट दैट अफेक्ट्स द आउटर साइड ऑफ द एल्बो. गोल्फर्स एल्बो हैज द सेम सिम्टम्स बट इट अफेक्ट्स द इनर साइड ऑफ द एल्बो. सो यू हैव बेसिकली हैव टू मेन मूवमेंट्स दैट अकर एट द रिस्ट. One is wrist extension and one is wrist flexion. Wrist extension is done by the extensor group of muscles which attach to the outer side of the elbow, whereas wrist flexion is done by the flexor group of muscles which attach to the inner side of the elbow. So golfer's elbow happens because the muscles on the inner side, which are attached to the bony prominence here, they get inflamed. This usually happens due to overuse injuries. The inflammation occurs here, it affects the elbow as well as all your wrist movements. So you have five main muscles that arise from here and go to your elbow and fingers. When this main tendon of attachment gets affected, it is called golfer's elbow. Coming to the causes of golfer's elbow, so it is caused due to, it is a repetitive strain injury or an overuse or an overload injury. So the main causes could be, first, because it's called golfer's elbow, so golfing, because of repeatedly hitting with the golfing club, you can get, if you have a form which is not okay, you can get inflammation in the tendons here. The second reason could be racket sports such as badminton, tennis or squash, especially when you're using the backhand, repeatedly using that can cause inflammation in the tendon. The third one is weightlifting. So if you're repeatedly lifting heavy weight with a lot of gripping at the gym and you're not using the right form, for example, when you are attempting bicep curls, but you're also flexing your wrist when you are curling, that causes a lot of strain on the inner side of the elbow. So that is one reason. The next reason is throwing activities. So playing baseball, throw ball or javelin throw with repeated flexion and extension of the elbow, you can again get inflammation in the tendons here. And the last cause could be your occupation. So if you're involved in activities where there is repetitive rotatory movements like carpentry, plumbing, construction or painting, all of that can also cause golfer's elbow. The symptoms of golfer's elbow are very similar to tennis elbow. So it usually starts with a dull kind of pain on the inner side here, and it might even radiate down your forearm, it might even reach your fingers in the later stages. You might also have some numbness and tingling in the little finger and the ring finger. The pain usually worsens early in the morning or after you do the activity which triggers the symptoms, like turning a doorknob, shaking hands. These are the activities that exaggerate the symptoms. You can also, in acute cases, have some amount of tenderness. That is when something touches you or if you apply pressure over this area, you will feel pain. There might also be redness, there might be warmth. And radiation occurs only in mostly in chronic cases. Eventually, you might also develop some stiffness with elbow movements and wrist movements. You might have difficulty forming a wrist or closing your fingers. So golfer's elbow, the main management for golfer's elbow is physiotherapy, but in the initial stages when the pain just starts, you can try icing the area because there's a lot of inflammation. So for 5 to 10 minutes you can keep an ice pack. You can do this 2 to 3 times a day. The second thing, you have to take a break from the particular sport or the activity which you know is triggering your symptoms or increasing your symptoms, so you have to stop doing that for 2-3 weeks. And also you have to brace. So there's a counterforce brace that comes. So you will find the bony prominence, you will keep your thumb there, so a gap of the thumb, and this is where you will wear the counterforce brace. This will decrease the tension and the strain on the muscle and the tendon, which can help you do the movements pain-free. So let's start with the exercises you can do for golfer's elbow. The first thing you will do is simple range of motion exercises for your wrist. Okay, so try and keep your hand on the armrest of a chair. Otherwise, you can also do it hanging it in the air, but this just provides a little bit more support. Okay, so your wrist should be beyond the level of the armrest. You will start with simple flexion and extension movements of the wrist. Okay, initially, just do flexion and extension. Once this feels like it is not very painful, you can flex and try and hold this position for 3 seconds. Same way, extend and hold the position for 3 seconds. So these are flexion and extension. You will do it 10 times and try to do 2 sets of each. The next one is radial and ulnar deviation. So same way, you will move the wrist to the sides. Again, there should be no movement happening here at the elbow. You can hold on to your arm and stabilize it. Only movement happening at the wrist. As much as possible, take it to the outside and bring it to the inner side. You can do it in this plane, or you can also turn your hand and do the same movement up and down. Again, 10 repetitions of each and 2 to 3 sets. The next one you will do is turning your wrist. So these movements are called pronation and supination, where you're facing the hand to the ceiling and down. This is supination, this is pronation. In case of golfer's elbow, pronation is the more painful movement. So that's what you will try to do. You will supinate your arm, which will give a good stretch to the forearm, and then slowly try to pronate as much as possible without causing a lot of pain. Again, you will try 10 repetitions and 2 sets of each. The next thing you can try is called cross-friction massage. So this mostly is done for chronic cases where you've had the pain for more than a month or two. There are chances that you have developed some scar tissue here because of microtrauma, which needs to be mobilized. So you will find the bony prominence at the elbow. You will keep your thumb or 2 fingers. And after that distance is where you will find the bulk of the tendon. This is your main problem point. So after finding that point, you will do up and down transverse movements with the thumb. This should be with a little bit of pressure. It might feel uncomfortable, but that is okay. It might also cause a little bit of pain, that is fine. You will try up and down movements, then you will try side to side movements, and in the end you can try circular movements, just trying to break the scar tissue and mobilize the tendon. So initial 20 to 30 seconds of doing this massage, you might feel a lot of pain and discomfort, but ideally within a minute of doing this, the pain should automatically start to come down. You will continue this for 3 minutes, but even after a minute, if you feel that there's a lot of pain and discomfort, you should stop this and try again after 2 to 3 days, because this means it is still acute and there's a lot of inflammation, then you should avoid doing it. The next exercise that you will do is stretching for the forearm muscles, both the flexors and the extensors. So you will keep your arm in front of you, elbow completely extended. Okay, you will start by stretching the flexor. So there are 2 ways that in which this can be done. The first one is with your fingers flexed, and the second one is with your fingers open. So when you do it with your fingers flexed or with a fist made, the stretch is a little less. It is a little mild. So in the initial stages, you can do it like this. With the fist made, you will hold on to your hand and pull it towards your body. You will feel a good stretch in your forearm. You will again hold this for 15 seconds to 30 seconds and do this 3 times. Same way, you will do it in the opposite direction. This will stretch your extensors. Okay, completely hold it for 15 to 30 seconds and relax. Once this feels comfortable, you can attempt to do the same thing with your fingers opened. This will provide a much bigger stretch. So again, hold on to your fingers and pull for 15 to 30 seconds, and in the same way, you will do it on the opposite side. Now let's come to the strengthening exercises that you can start now. So there is wrist curls, which are of 2 types, concentric and eccentric. This one, where you're entirely doing the movement with your affected arm only, is called concentric. This can be done in the later stages, but in the initial stages, doing this can further aggravate your pain. So in the initial stages, you will do the eccentric type of wrist curls. So what you will do is, you will hold the dumbbell in your fingers in a hook grip like this. You will do the flexion of the wrist with the help of the other hand, taking most of the weight. And then when you take it down into extension is where you are doing the movement yourself in a controlled way. Again, dumbbell in your fingers, you will use your other hand to lift up, and the downward movement is what you will do with your affected arm. So this helps in strengthening the muscle, but without causing too much load. So again, you will do around 10 repetitions of this and 2 sets. The next exercise is your pronation and supination. You've already done the normal movement. Now you will just add a dumbbell to it for strengthening purposes. But here you will hold the dumbbell vertically up so that the heavy side is up here. This will provide a little bit of stretch also. So you will start moving your arm down. Controlled movement as much as possible till there is not a lot of pain, and then again you will lift it up and rotate it to the opposite side. Again, you can use your other hand to stabilize down and up. So maybe start with only a 1/2 kg dumbbell and then you can progress to 1-1.5 kg. You will do 10 repetitions, 2 sets. Next one is called an isometric. So again, you will do it for both the flexors and the extensors. So start with your palm facing the floor. You will just hold on to a dumbbell. You will take a heavier weight, up to 2 kgs also. And all you have to do is just hold your palm in a neutral position. So not flexed, not extended, just in a neutral position. You will try to hold this for at least 30 to 45 seconds. And once you feel that shiver in your forearm, you can let it go. Again, same thing, but with your palm facing the ceiling, you will just hold the weight again for 30 to 45 seconds. So it should be heavy so that you feel that your forearm muscles are working hard. And you will just hold it. And then once you feel the fatigue and the tiredness in the muscles, you can slowly leave it loose. The next exercise we will do is bicep curls. So this is basically for your arm strength. Your biceps are attached to your elbow, therefore it is important also to strengthen the biceps. So again, you will hold on to a lighter weight in the initial stages. You will bend your elbow, try to bring it as close to your shoulder as possible. Then slowly you will take it back down. Again, make sure this movement would be easy, but taking it back down can be a little painful. So don't suddenly drop your arm. It is a slow flexion of your elbow and a slow and controlled extension. Also, you will make sure when you are lifting, you are not bending at the elbow, at the wrist. You will not bend at the wrist and do it, because this will further stretch the inner side of your elbow and cause pain. So your wrist has to be in a neutral position. The only movement that is happening is at the elbow. Again, you will do around 10 repetitions, 2 sets. The next exercise is for your grip strength, which would have weakened over a period of time. So you can do it in 3 ways. If you have a hand gripper, you can just use that. Loop your fingers around it and just pull, curl, curl your wrist, and then again curl your fingers and leave it again. Initially, you can just do open and close. Once this feels easy, you can make a fist and then try and hold this for 3 to 5 seconds and then let it go. If you don't have a hand gripper, you can either use a rubber ring or the smiley yellow ball that you get. Again, hold it with your fingers, press it with your fingers, try and hold it for a few seconds and then relax. Again, you will try to do this 10 times, maybe just one set of this. If you don't have this either, you can just use a simple towel, roll it, hold onto the towel and just a simple pressing it with as much strength as possible and lead. So these are the grip strength exercises you can do in 3 ways. Please try all of these stretches and strengthening exercises for at least 2 to 3 weeks. If your symptoms still persist or if they get exaggerated, please go meet a doctor or a physiotherapist. If you like our videos, please like, share and subscribe to our channel and witness your fitness with us.